की बड़ी बात आपका शुक्र
ये देखिए यहाँ से ओके यस सो हाउ आर यू ऑल फीलिंग एनर्जेटिक थम्स अप ओके गुड आई होप सो यू मस्ट बी फीलिंग गुड एंड लेट्स हैव अ स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक ऑफ द डे एंड आई होप सो यू मस्ट हैव डन योर टास्क व्हिच आई असाइंड यू ऑन यस्टरडे एंड दैट इज द प्रेपोजिशंस ऑफ पोजीशन ऑल ऑफ यू हैव डन दैट PDF that worksheet which I provided you. Good. And did you watch the video also relevant to that prepositions of position? Okay, good. Now, students, let's have a start with our topic of the day. And today we are going to read about the use of its and its. Both are its, but one with the apostrophe and the other one without it as a possessive pronoun. So let me display the slide before you all. Yes, so this is your topic for the day and that is grammar focus. It's exercise E and here we are going to learn about use of its with apostrophe and its as a possessive pronoun. Let us see what is its with apostrophe is used for and what is actually its meaning. Now, as you can see, its with apostrophe like this comma which you can see right after it, it is a punctuation mark. Okay, this is the symbol or punctuation mark and we call this punctuation mark as apostrophe. We call it as apostrophe. So, sometime it is used right after it and after it, after this apostrophe there is s, okay? Though we say it its, now, we can say that its this its with apostrophe is the short form or contraction of either it is or it has. Okay, this is the short form or contraction of complete forms it is or it has. Now check this next slide. Here you can see read this information. We always use apostrophe with its when it is used as a contraction of it is or it has. The same information which I conveyed you earlier that we use this apostrophe with it when we want to show it as the short form of the complete forms it is or it has. Clear now? Actually, this apostrophe or this punctuation mark is an indication that some letter has been dropped. Some letter has been dropped in a word. Like, let me move here with its here. In its, you can see that in the complete form, there is, it is. Now, while we are writing the contraction or short form, instead of writing I of is, we have put what? Apostrophe here, okay? And please stop this scribbling. Okay, so we were just talking about that, about the apostrophe. Like you can see here in case of it is, I dropped I and I wrote its. You may write its, okay? And then in case of it has, you have dropped the letter H-A, okay, H-A, and then you have written the short form, its. So it's with apostrophe is the short form of it is or it has. Let's move to the next slide now. You can see here another it's. Can you find any apostrophe here in this it's? No apostrophe here. Okay. So here it's is not the contraction or short form of it is or it has, which we discussed in the last slides. Okay. Here it's is not the short form or contraction of it is or it has. It is actually the possessive pronoun of it. Here it's is the possessive pronoun of it, and its meaning is belonging to something, ownership or possession. Here the meaning of it's is when we use it's with without apostrophe, its meaning becomes belonging to something, ownership or possession. Fine. Let's move to the next slide. Again, apostrophe. We don't use apostrophe with its as a possessive pronoun. So my dear student, I told you earlier that apostrophe is used with its while we are using its as a contraction or short form of it is or it has. But if we use it as a possessive pronoun of it, then there is no need to use apostrophe or this punctuation mark with it. Very simple, we write it its without using apostrophe when we are using it as a possessive pronoun. So keep these key informations in your mind, because you would be handling with an exercise where you are required to write either it's with apostrophe or it's without apostrophe. Okay, how to pronounce it's as a contraction or short form of it is or it has or it's? How do we pronounce it? There is no change in their pronunciation, though there is change in their forms. Its form is different as compared to it. There is apostrophe with the first it's, and there is no apostrophe with the second one. There is change in their form. And this, the first it's is the contraction or short form of it is or it has, and the second one is the possessive pronoun of it, pronoun, personal pronoun it. And similarly, there is a change in their use also. Okay. So there is a change in their form, in their meaning, and in their uses, but there is no change in their pronunciation. Their sound is same, their pronunciation is same. We shall say is its, and also we shall say it as its. So the sound and the pronunciation of both these is its. No change in their pronunciation, though there is change in their form, in their meaning, and in their use. Now let us handle with the examples of it's as a contraction or short form of it is or it has. Remember, dear student, this it with apostrophe is the short form or contraction of it is or it has. Okay. Now let us deal with the example of this it as a contraction or short form. First, example number one. It's a nice car. Okay, now if we split this it or this contraction it's, we can say the complete sentence like it is a nice car. Okay, this is where we have split this it's, this contraction, into its complete form, and then it would be turned like this: it is a nice car. Come to the second one. It's hot today. Again, here it has been used as a contraction of it is. It is hot today. Fine. Now come to the third example. It's been drizzling in Oman since morning. I told you earlier that it's with this apostrophe is used sometime as a short form of it is and sometime as a short form of it has. Like here in the last example, third one, you can find that here it's is used as a short form of it has. In the first two one, it was used as a short form of it is, and in this last one it has been used as a short form of it has. So here I read it or split it into complete form. It has been drizzling in Oman since morning. Now in the fourth example again, it's been long time. Let me use the complete form of this. It's again, it has been used as the contraction of it has. It has been long time. Wherever, so dear student, you find in a sentence there is been, wherever you find that there is a been, then you must come up with this solution that here it's is used, it's with apostrophe is used as a contraction or short form of it has. Wherever you find this been, you may come up to this solution that it's is used as a short form of it has. But you can find that in the first two example there is no been. Okay, so here we mean that it's is a contraction of it is. Is everything clear to you? Thank you. Okay, so let us see that what is the important note here given in the end. In the first two sentences, like you can see in the example one and example two, it stand for it is, and in the last two sentences, like third and the fourth one, it's with apostrophe stands for it has. Now let's move to the other slide, examples of its. Now these are the examples of the its without apostrophe or its which is the possessive pronoun of the personal pronoun it. Okay, its is a, its here has been used as a possessive pronoun of it. Let us see the first example. The bird is in its nest. Like you can see, its nest, it means this nest is the possession of this bird, the subject. So here it is used as a possessive pronoun, possession of bird, possession or ownership of this bird. Its nest is the possession or ownership of this bird, the subject. Come to the next example. Second, the cat carried the kitten in its mouth. Now again here it has been used as a possessive pronoun. This its without apostrophe is used as a possessive pronoun. It's like, it is the possession of this cat. Mouth is the possession of the cat where it is carrying the two kittens, or where in which it is carrying the kittens, its babies. The third one, the library has lost all its books. Books again show the possession. Its books show the possession of the library. So books are the possession of the library. That's why we use its with books. Here it's all have been, it's the example of it has, it's been used as a possessive pronoun. So what do we summarize finally? We summarize finally that it is a possessive pronoun. We summarize it is a possessive pronoun. This it's, I'm talking about this it's, okay? Now let's move to the next it's. Now the next it's, like you can see, it's with apostrophe. It's with apostrophe. Let me highlight also this one. Is a contraction or short form of either either it is or it has. So this is the summary for the whole, that how I'm just talking about this. It's so, let us see what is the summary, or in short we can say that it's without apostrophe is a possessive pronoun, and it's with apostrophe is a contraction or short form of either it is or it has. Just keep these key points in your mind, and now I'm going to assign your task which you are supposed to do by your own. You may see it on your screen, okay? This is your task. Here you are required to fill in the blanks with either its or its. Now keeping that knowledge about its with apostrophe and its without apostrophe, fill in these blanks. Take 5 minutes to do it, and then you may give me the answers by showing them on the screen. Write it on a page, prominently on a page, with 1, 2, 3, 4. Only the answers display with the number, okay? Only the answers should be with the numbers. Take 5 minutes, please, to do this exercise, that either you are going to use this it's with apostrophe or it's without apostrophe, okay, as a possessive pronoun. Take 5 minutes, please, and do this task. On a paper, just write with the number one, if you are going to use it's with apostrophe or without apostrophe, or number two, just their answers, not the whole of the statements, fine? I'm waiting for your response. Yes, thank you so much for your answers. I hope so everyone would have done this exercise. Let me share the exact answer with you all. The first one is it's with apostrophe. Now you match your answers with me, with my answers, okay? Listen the answers and match your answers with it. It's with apostrophe. First one is it's with apostrophe. Second one, it's without apostrophe. Third one, it's with apostrophe. Fourth one, again, it's with apostrophe. And last one, it's without apostrophe. These are the answers for your blanks, okay? I hope so many of you would have done in a right way. If not, do it now in a right way, fine? And let me share the other slide with you, the last task. This is your second task, where you are required to make 3 sentences for it's without apostrophe and it's with apostrophe, okay? So this task you are going to do once the meeting is ended, okay? This is your task as a homework. Now what you are going to do now, I require you to please open your books of English on the page 20. On the page 20, please open your books of English. Yes, have you opened your pages on page 20, where you can find the exercise, the last one, the fourth question. Let me read the question statement. Rewrite these sentences by capitalizing the initial letters of the names of days and months. Have you opened your books on the page 20? You all? Good. And the last exercise, please look at the last exercise. This last exercise, let me read the first. Here you are required to use capital letter with the capital letter with the days and the months. Now how you are going to write the capital letters or use the capital letter with the days and the months? As I told you earlier, that the specific names of the days, day is a common noun, day, the word day itself is a common noun, but when we give it a specific name, like specific name, Sunday could be the specific name, Monday, Saturday, this is the specific name for a day. And when we use the specific name for a common noun or for a day, then we use the first letter as a capital letter, or write the first letter as a capital letter for the specific name of the day. And similarly, month, the word month, M-O-N-T-H, month, is a common name of all the months, is a common name which is used for a duration of 30 days. Okay, this is a common name which is used for the duration of 30 or 31 days, or even 29 or 28 days. But when we give it a specific name, this month, when we give it a specific name, then it becomes a proper noun, and its first letter would be capitalized. The day when we give it a specific name, it becomes a proper noun, and the month when we give it a specific name, it turns into a proper noun. And remember, with proper nouns, their first letter is always capitalized. The first letter of the proper nouns or days or months, their specific name is always capitalized. Now here you have been given four statements you have been given. He will visit us next Sunday. You find the day here, the specific day, or the proper nouns in each sentence, and then write its first letter as capital. Find the name of the day or the month, and then its initial or first letter must be capitalized. Do this exercise, please. Take some time and do this exercise right now on your book. Are you doing this exercise? Very good, nice. Yes, keep doing it. Good, I can see that many of you have done, and they are displaying their books before me that they have done this exercise. Very good, but still many are doing. So take your time and do it calmly. Good, very good. I can see Abu Bakr. Good. How about Sally? Have you done? Asagar and yes, Bhavya. Exercise is done by you? Good. Bhavya is done. Muhammad Saleem, is it done by you? Very good. Oh, Ashna has also done. Very good, Ashna. Varda has done. Good. Abdullah, how about you? Have you done? Abdullah Shakur, have you done? Thumbs up. Very good, Abdullah. I was expecting the same from you. And Sadeen, you have also done? Oh, very good. Almost everyone has done. Yes, Marwa, how about you? Your exercise is complete. Okay, Abiha has also done. Good. Subhan has also done. Good. Yes, what about you, Burhan? Burhan was also here. Now let us check your answers, the right answers. Please, I display the sheet with the right answers and you match your answers with it, okay? I'm displaying the slide before you. Yes, now check your answers and match them with this. Can you see this on your gadget screen? This text with the right answers or the solved one? Match your answers with it, please, if you have done in a right way or not. Is it displayed on your screen? This sheet, the question, the filled up question, question four on your gadget screen. Can you see it? Good, very good. Now match your answers with it. If you're right in writing the capital letters in a right way, Like you can see, dear students, he will visit us next Sunday. Here you can see that the day is, the proper noun is what? Sunday. Okay, and its first letter has been capitalized. Yes, Varda. Okay, very good. You have done good. Now match your answers with it. Second, they will meet on first Monday of April. Here you can see two proper nouns, Monday and April. So the first letter of Monday would be capitalized, and the first letter of April, A, would be capitalized. Third, she is going to her uncle's house in July. I told you earlier that uncle, when you are using a common noun instead of using the name of a person, okay, like here uncle, his name we have not used, but specifically we want to emphasize his name and we are using uncle instead of his name, so it is to be taken as a proper noun. So U of uncle would be capitalized. She is going to her uncle, U of uncle would be capitalized, and July the month, it is a proper noun, so J would be capitalized. Now come to the last one. They have been living in this village since December. You can see one proper noun has been used here, and that is the name of the month, D. D is to be capitalized here for December. Now you all please match your answer. If anything is wrong, erase it and do it in the right way, and always do the exercise on your book with a pencil, not with a pen. And one more thing, as you can see here in this statement, you can see that it is to be done in your notebook. This exercise you are supposed to do in your notebook also, okay? This exercise with right answers, okay?